AMD just killed DLSS, and basically all gamers will benefit from this, even NVIDIA gamers. Tonight, AMD held their keynote presentation for virtual Computex 2021. I honestly haven't been paying much attention to these presentations, as most have not announced anything too interesting, but AMD came in swinging. First, they announced the Ryzen 5000 series APUs are going to be available on August 5th. Yes, that's high core count APUs from the new Zen 3 CPUs. The Ryzen 6 5600G comes in at 6 cores, 12 threads, boosts up to 4.4 GHz, and has a 65-watt TDP for $259. The Ryzen 7 5700G comes in at 8 cores, 16 threads, boosts up to 4.6 GHz, and has a 65-watt TDP for $359. They showed that one running Road Company at high graphics at around 70 FPS at 1080p resolution. These are impressive and a much-needed boost to the GPU scarce market at the moment, but while they mentioned great performance and creative apps, I don't think they will have the advantage there, with QuickSync being very powerful in video editors like Adobe Premiere Pro and the new 422, H.264, and HEVC decode on Rocket Lake being a huge deal. Get subscribed for a video on that, finally. Next, Dr. Lisa Su moved on to Tesla cars. I mean, RDNA 2, passing off to Scott Herkelman. After some flexing, it was stated that RDNA 2 is coming to Samsung Exynos SoCs, bringing ray tracing and variable rate shading to mobile games, which could be huge. Like, whoa. These kinds of visuals making their way to mobile games quickly accelerates the parity between modern console games and mobile games to incredibly exciting levels, and if they somehow also introduce another feature that we'll talk about in a little bit, the paradigm could shift pretty drastically here. Laptops get high-performance graphics too, with Radeon RX 6000M coming to laptops. The AMD RX 6800M will have a 2300 MHz game clock, 12GB of GDDR6 memory, and releasing in late June in laptops like the ROG Strix G15. For their performance numbers, they were comparing to 2019 laptops. This is a little bit silly in terms of actual performance flexing, but the objective seemed to be to provide upgrades for those who already had gaming laptops, I guess. AMD pushed the 6800M as the mobile GPU for 120 FPS gaming at 1440p max settings in many titles with 60 plus FPS on AAA games. They claim 1.12 to 1.4x faster performance on battery than the 3080M too, due to better energy efficiency. We'll see if that holds up. Other mobile GPUs will include the 6700M with 10GB of VRAM aimed at 1440p 100Hz gaming, and the 6600M with 8GB of VRAM aimed at 1080p 120fps gaming. It's time for me to eat my words, but before we do, snack on this bill-paying sponsor segue. I'm rushing to make this video at midnight because getting content up at launch feeds the YouTube algorithm, but my creator friends and I sought to build a new video site where we didn't have to worry about these silly things. The site is called Nebula, and we've partnered with CuriosityStream. Nebula features YouTube's top education creators such as MKBHD, Thomas Frank, and LowSpecGamer. CuriosityStream saw what we were doing for educational content and wanted to partner up. We've worked out a deal where if you sign up with the link down below, down there, you not only get access to CuriosityStream and their library of thousands of documentary and educational videos and content, you get access to Nebula, our creator streaming site, for free for the entire duration of your subscription to CuriosityStream, which is pretty bonkers. And for a limited time, CuriosityStream is running a sale 26% off of their annual plan, making it less than $15 per year for both CuriosityStream and Nebula. While you're there, check out Pizza, a Love Story. Do I really need to say more this time? It's about pizza. Everyone loves pizza. I'm gonna go order me a pizza right now. But you should head to curiositystream.com/epos and order yourself the best deal in streaming, because it's pretty bonkers. Just do it. And actually, instead of pizza, I'm gonna have to eat my words about FidelityFX Super Resolution. FidelityFX Super Resolution, which I am struggling to say here, I have mocked it for years as being presented as nothing more than a basic sharpening filter, but it's actually going to be game-changing moving forward. If you're unfamiliar, I'm going to call it FSR from now on, because that's what they're calling it, and that's easier to say. FSR is AMD's attempt at replicating NVIDIA's DLSS technology without AI. It's integrating into a game's rendering pipeline and reconstructing the image from a lower resolution render without sacrificing much quality while gaining a huge performance boost. Game consoles have been doing something similar for a whole generation now, and it's worked out pretty well. Originally, FSR wasn't anything to write home about, hence my history of mocking it, but they've been hard at work kind of figuring it out and making a better production out of it. And meanwhile, DLSS has been absolutely incredible, but competition breeds innovation. Rather than being built upon AI training models and the like, AMD is using a spatial upscaling algorithm to reconstruct the image. In their demo, they showed Godfall running at a native 4K with epic settings and RT on, ray tracing, reaching 48 FPS on their big 6800 XT GPU, but with FSR, 78 FPS. Damn, that's an impressive performance boost, and this was on the ultra quality mode, as there are four different quality modes for FSR, much like DLSS. But they didn't just show it running on their own GPU. They also demoed FSR running on an NVIDIA GTX 1060, showing a 41% performance gain for the same kind of scenario. Yeah, a 1060. AMD has built FSR to be open for the entire industry to freely access, meaning it can be run on basically any GPU as long as the developer adds the technology into their game engine. If you've seen any talks about the incredible results gained from DLSS over on Digital Foundry, then you've heard them discuss the need for a more open platform for this to make sure all gamers can get this very important performance boost and not have to hamstring things based on if the game is AMD sponsored or NVIDIA sponsored. AMD just gave that to us. Well, they will in a few weeks. Much like how FreeSync knocked down the proprietary walls of G-Sync, FSR is doing the same to DLSS. As of June 22nd, FSR will be enabled on Radeon 500, Vega, Radeon 5000, and Radeon 6000 GPUs, as well as all of AMD's APUs that use Radeon graphics as well. That's over 100 GPUs and CPUs from AMD at launch that will support it. Plus, FSR will run on any 10 series or newer NVIDIA GPU as well. And theoretically, it should be able to be ported to run on newer Intel iGPUs or their Xe-D GPUs in time, too. This is incredible. 10 game devs and engines are on board already, which isn't a lot, but more are inevitably coming. What would be even better is if they could get it running on those Samsung SoCs or on the Xbox or PlayStation, though those consoles have already had their own dynamic resolution scaling standards anyway. While yes, in many cases, FSR may provide worse results than DLSS, that will not matter in the long run. Much like with FreeSync versus G-Sync, FSR will get you 90% of the way there, and that, combined with the open nature allowing all gamers to benefit from it, means that developers will be far more likely to implement it. And everyone wins from that kind of situation, really. It's honestly just free performance. It's free performance. That isn't the only major announcement that AMD had in store for today, but they had to take another break to talk about laptops. The big thing for me from this part of the talk was that AMD Advantage laptops have AMD Smart Shift and Smart Access Memory, allowing the system to dynamically balance CPU and GPU power, much like the PlayStation 5, to tune a better overall gaming experience. All AMD Advantage laptops will have 144Hz FreeSync Premium monitors included as well. Neat. We end on a high note for CPUs. Dr. Su notes that AMD is right on track for their 5-nanometer process, whatever that means, with products still aiming to be available next year. But they've made a big leap in something else. AMD has innovated their packaging technology with 3D chiplet technology, adding a 3D vertical cache to their CPUs. This allows them to slap a 64MB 7-nanometer SRAM on top of the individual CCDs with greater than 2 TB per second of bandwidth, and sealed up with a seamless surface on the combined chip. Dr. Su whipped out a prototype 5900X with 3D chiplet technology already implemented too. This results in 96MB of cache per CCD, 192MB in total. Wowzers. A greater than 200 times interconnect density was touted, allowing AMD a more efficient and denser integration of their tech into the CPU process. A prototype 5900X with 3D chiplet cache was demoed versus a standard one, and the performance was pretty impressive. They were showing 184 FPS on the standard 5900X versus 206 FPS on the 3D chip at the same thread counts and clock speeds. 15% performance improvements on average have been claimed for these CPUs. Production on these 3D chiplet CPUs should begin by end of year, but it is the current year after all, so we'll see if we ever actually see them in person one day. Oddly, there was no mention of Threadripper at all. Threadripper with Zen 3 was supposed to come out this year, right? Perhaps they're integrating the 3D chiplets for it? I'm not sure, but I was disappointed at its absence. But I certainly can't say I was disappointed in the overall presentation here, honestly. Like, it was awesome. FSR coming to all GPUs, effectively, is a huge deal, and the implications and results from this could make a ripple across gaming for years to come. I, for one, am stoked, and I want to get my hands on those APUs. What was your favorite segment or mention from today's presentation? Join us on Discord and chat with us about it. I'm EposVox, the Stream Professor. We'll meet again.